It was 4:30 in the morning. The lights were glowing brightly in the Sultan's chamber. Shahrazade, the story is excellent. You're really great in telling excellent stories.
Your Highness, there is another story about a fisherman, which is much more interesting than this.
Please tell me the story.
But Your Highness, it's almost dawn. If I start the story now, I can complete it tomorrow only.
All right, let me postpone your punishment by one more day.
Thank you, my lord. Let me start the story. Once upon a time, a fisherman was living in a small village near the seashore. He was very old and poor, but had to support his wife and three children. Every day he went to fish, and each day he made a rule not to throw his nets more than 4 times. He started out one morning by moonlight and came to the seashore. He threw his nets, and as he was drawing them towards the bank, he felt a heavy pull.
Oh God, it is very heavy. I think it must be a big fish.
But moments after, instead of a fish, to his disappointment, it was only a body of a donkey. He threw his net in for the second time.
It's very heavy. I think there must be loads of fish.
He dragged the net.
How unlucky I am. I have got only rubbish.
He threw the net for the third time. Again, it was very heavy.
I at least hope this time it is a big fish.
He dragged, but he got some shells loaded with mud.
Oh God, have mercy on me. Please help me. My wife and kids depend on me.
He threw the net for the fourth and final time. It was very heavy, and with great difficulty he dragged it. To his surprise, he saw a pot with a copper lid on it.
What is this? Is it a treasure? If it is a treasure, I should take it to the king, give it, and get money for buying some wheat for the family.
He shook the pot to find out if there was something inside. No sound was heard. He broke the lid. Immediately, a thin line of smoke emerged from the pot. Slowly, slowly, the smoke became big and a thick smoke appeared in front of the fisherman. At last, a huge, terrific-looking monster appeared before him. Fisherman hid himself behind a rock in fear. He could not speak a word as he was tongue-tied.
Fisherman, come out!
The fisherman came out from the rock shivering.
I am going to kill you.
Now the fisherman got angry. He used all his guts and spoke.
What do you mean? For freeing you from the pot, you want to kill me?
Yes. I was inside this pot for 300 years. In the first century, I thought that if someone freed me, I will give them enormous wealth. But none freed me. In the second century, I thought I'll make a person as the king if someone frees me. Now, help me. Vexed with all these, I decided to kill the person who saves me. Now, you have freed me.
Fisherman thought of a plan.
Monster! Don't try to fool me with all these stories. You're so huge and you want me to believe that you have come out of this.
If you don't believe, look at me carefully. I will go inside and come out to show that I was inside the pot.
The fisherman watched carefully. he waited for the monster to get inside completely. As soon as it went in, he hurriedly took the lid and closed it tight on the jar.
You have cheated me. Why have you put me again inside? I will get you all the riches. Please let me free.
Am I a fool to believe you? You have cheated me. If I leave you, you will treat me in the same way how the Greek king treated the physician Duban.
What do you mean? Tell me.